Honorable Minister of Education, the State of Assam, Sri Siddhartha Bhattacharya. Honorable Chancellor of this University, Mr. Hawk. The Vice Chancellor, Professor Goswami. The Advisor, Principal, Dr. Nirmal Kumar Chaudhuri. Advisor Sharma. All other distinguished guests on the dais, of the dais, parents and guardians, most importantly the students, even more importantly the freshers joining the first semester after 12 or first semester of the postgraduate after the first degree. Media persons, ladies and gentlemen. Such a day to a university is extremely important because it makes a beginning for hundreds of youths for the rest of their life. And so are we here today. From my heart, I would like to first congratulate all the students who would be able to make it to this university, about which you have heard from Mr. Hawk, the founding chancellor of this university, and his vision. I have been having the fortune to see it growing almost from the first year. So I have not much to add, but to justify in saying that he is justified in whatever he has said. As I said, today is the day for the students. So before I proceed to say a few words to the very newcomer, I would also like to join this institution in congratulating all the 27 people sitting here. You have brought laurel for yourself, to your parents, to your states, and to all of us, and above all to this institution. It's a hard-earned competitive examination, all India level. It's not very easy to secure such a number in such a short time. Keep it up, sky is the limit. My dear newcomers, I have a few tips for you because the people who have come after 12 class, they have just come out of the PGM, out of the control of their parents. And in one jump, there is a paradigm shift that you have come for a closet to a free world. Here is the place where you have people from 12 plus to post-doctorate. So please hear me carefully, don't get lost. It is time that you have to control yourself. Of course, the institution will do its bit, so will your parents, but it is more of you that you have to be careful. The other point, and this point gets a very much relevant, particularly for 12 plus passouts. Little less for the first degree holder, because they have matured to some extent by now after their graduation, either from this institution or from any other institution, wheresoever. But still, even for them, there is a word of caution, and be careful. Guwahati is the biggest city, if I may claim, in the whole of region. So there are a lot of entertainment facilities, eateries, blah, blah, blah. And those are attractions for the very young people to get deviated from their main theme for which they have come over here. So be careful. Second thing, young friends, you had so far gone through yearly examination, then board examination, and so forth. Now you are in an university system which is directly guided, as far as the academics are concerned, by the University Grants Commission. So you have, or even I have, no other go but to stick to the mandates. And therefore, you are now going to encounter semester system. And in a semester system, my dear friends, let me give you the trick of the trade. every day is important, not the final exam or the mid-session exam. Every day is important, so be very, very careful. If you are careful, it is difficult to fail. If you are careless, obviously it will be difficult to pass. I must tell you. Next is that there are certain new things going to come up the moment your classes start. Be careful about that. Those I will not be elaborating, but I will just enumerate by the phrases. Your faculty members and other experts who are coming to address you for your introduction, they will perhaps elaborate more. They are semester system, I have already said. Continuous evaluation is yet another thing. You have to be very, very careful, but there is a charm in that. Then choice-based credit system, which many of you might not have heard, if not all. So this is yet another parameter which is going to be imposed, because University Grants Commission has made it compulsory from 2015 that not only the universities, but even all the colleges have to have. So about CBCS, choice-based credit system, again I will not elaborate, because today for me it is not the time. Some other experts will explain to you, but you must understand and take the full benefit of it. Friends, this institution is one of those unique places where people have come from so many states of Northeast and maybe even beyond that. So it's a place of national integration. My appeal to all of you would be, please learn brotherhood, learn how to live together with others in peace and tranquility, give something to others, take something more from others, and live together. So therefore, it is very, very important that be disciplined on the campus, off the campus, so that nobody can raise a finger, oh, they are USTM students, they are not good. They should say that they are USTM students, they are very good, they are very disciplined, we like to learn from you. Next is, friends, please hear me carefully. From 2nd of October, the 150th anniversary celebration for the father of the nation, Mahatma Gandhi, is going to start. And you, along with your faculty members and the management, try to articulate your program. You decide, you devise the items, etc., so that this can be done in a befitting manner. I am not worried how much publicity you give. I am worried how much seriousness you have, what lessons, particularly the youths, have taken from that. I'll quickly come in a couple of minutes, for a couple of minutes now. I have something to share with the faculty members and the management. You see, while it is very important to give orientation to the students, which Mr. Hawk and his staff have arranged, I understand it is a week-long program, it's a must, and it's a very good thing, but Mr. Hawk and the vice-chancellors and other organizers of this institution, management, I must tell you, it is equally important, if not more, is to also refresh and orient your teachers, especially the younger teachers, more especially the first-time recruits. Because the art of teaching learning has changed, and so they must be first equipped to that through lectures and through some hands-on, and then be given to the students, otherwise things are going to be lost. My dear students and the faculty members, also remember, gone are the days of monologue. A teacher comes, gives a lecture or series of lectures, and be done with. This is just not permissible. Even yesterday, it was discussed at length at Assam Raj Bhavan. Governor himself was there. Secretary of UGC was himself present throughout the day. What has been emphasized, that ICT has to be involved as far as possible. Digitization has to be the order of the day. And adherence to the norms and regulations of University Grants Commission and AICT be also stuck to. There are certain new things that we may have to discuss with the faculty member. There is a felony, more than a misdemeanor, is plagiarism. Plagiarism, it starts right from, almost from first semester. And it's very, very unfortunate, it has to be stopped. Cutting, pasting, my dear student, without acknowledging, is stealing somebody else's work, it is just not, as I said, it is a felony. It's a crime. This is not permissible. And all the more as you go up to the research. So this may be taken care of, particularly the management and the teachers I am referring to. Last point, there is a call from our Honorable Prime Minister. What he says that New India, and he feels that the gross enrollment ratio, which is a parameter for higher education, has to be raised to 30 by 2022. And this can be done not by the government alone. Government, whosoever may be there, whichever country you may refer to, government alone cannot fund this colossal amount of education. So therefore, private institutions, private-public partnership has to become. Now let me tell you also the students, for a matter of joke even, if somebody says, oh, you are in a private institution, you should not feel let down. Government of India has given equal status to private institution as much as they have given to public institution. So much so that Prime Minister himself also through MHRD announced 10 best universities in the private sector, 10 best in the public sector will be rewarded heavily in terms of fund, grants, in terms of autonomy and whatsoever. First part of this exercise, which took place this year, identified 2+2 institutions. Please hear me very carefully. Two public funded institutions, one each like Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, which obviously is the best institution in the country, and one of the IITs, most probably IIT Bombay. And two private institutions, you must hear me carefully, have also been given the same platform, same status, Manipal and BITS Pilani. So friends, you are on the same board as the public funded institution students are. You must take the best out of it. I wish and pray to Almighty for the very best for you. You have a long journey to go, but don't get worried. There will be stumbles, but there are ways how to cross. Thank you very much. I also thank the management for asking me to come here.